Infusing more food with micronutrients is considered one of the most promising ideas in development economics. According to some estimates, maternal and child undernutrition is an underlying cause of 3.5 million deaths a year and over a third of the disease burden in children younger than 5. Almost a third of the developing world does not consume iodized salt, and they're thus vulnerable to goiter and also, in general, cognitive deficiencies. At least 100 million children still suffer from vitamin A deficiency, and it's estimated that at least 2 billion people have too little iron in their diet. There's plenty of evidence that workers who have enough iron are much more productive than workers who do not. The three major micronutrient issues are typically considered to be iodine, iron, and vitamin A, but other examples would be folates and zinc. It's remarkable how cheaply additional micronutrients can be added to food. Iron supplements, for instance, are estimated to cost about 10 cents per person per year. Salt with iodine is estimated to cost about 5 cents per person per year. When economists do cost-benefit studies of micronutrients, they very typically find extreme ratios of benefit to cost, for instance, sometimes in the neighborhood of 30 to 1. This led a group called the Copenhagen Consensus some number of years ago to suggest that micronutrients were the single most important priority for improving life in the developing world. There's both an optimistic and a pessimistic take on micronutrients. The optimistic take, of course, is that there really are very large possible improvements on the table. The notion that micronutrients would greatly help the developing world has not proven controversial. The pessimistic take is to note that, to a large extent, this hasn't yet been done, and that suggests there are serious problems in developing economies. The evidence indicates that simply passing a law mandating micronutrients isn't nearly enough. The actual problem is one of sustainability and coordinated action. For instance, a micronutrients program might involve inspection of food supply sources, monitoring, and also public education to tell people that, in fact, micronutrients are important. In developing countries, the food producers are often very small and very local, and reaching them with the knowledge and capability to put more micronutrients in the food isn't always that easy. Furthermore, over the longer haul, these smaller producers have to see that they can incur the additional expense of micronutrients, even if it's a small one, and remain financially viable in the longer run. It has to look to them like it's something that's going to help their profits rather than hurt them. In any case, micronutrients are a vital issue for the economics of food. For further reading in this area and some sources, Google simply micronutrients and also micronutrients Copenhagen Consensus and read some of the papers they've produced on this topic.